afternoon and welcome to the Countdown studio on the day way back in 1990 that American fashion designer Roy Halston Frohick sadly passed away, better known in the world of fashion simply as Halston. He was just an extraordinarily influential American designer. And who will ever forget Jacqueline Kennedy? Of course, she was a style icon herself. And at her husband's inauguration back in 1961, she wore the famous pillbox. And rather sadly, Rachel, of course, she was wearing a pillbox on the day that he was gunned down in Dealey Plaza in November 1963. But Halston was the man in those days, and he was at Studio 54, of course, which is the nightclub. Bianca Jagger, she was there. And Liza Minnelli was there, and, of course, Andy Warhol. He was the sort of, you know, the centre of the creative New York in those days. And I know pretty much nothing about...
You're not a clubber?
No. But there's
raver?
One... Raver?
Are you a raver?
No.
No?
Never was.
Surprise me, Nick.
I don't know what a nightclub looks like. I went to Annabelle's once. Outrageously expensive. I didn't know what it was all about. But now you're swanning around London. Are you visiting all those Mahiki and all those fashionable places?
I'm not much of a clubber, actually.
You're not out every Thursday, Friday and Saturday?
No, I prefer a cocktail bar. I like a dance, but I'm not much of a raver.
All right. All right. Well, we'll see what we can do. Now then, who have we got with us? We've got Tom Kappelman back again. 5 wins under his belt. He's gone for the 6th today. You had a great performance yesterday, 120. Not your highest score, I think. 135 was your highest?
Yeah.
Tremendous performer. And I think you got all the numbers games. Is that right?
I missed one, I think.
You missed one? Well, that's not good enough, Tom. Now, you're joined today by Mike Pilkington, a retired bingo club proprietor from Billinge near St Helens, a volunteer ambassador for the Stroke Association. Am I right, Mike?
That's right, yes.
And you've done a lot of daring activities in the skies. Parasailing, hot air ballooning. Are these for the charity? Or?
No, that was pre-stroke. That was a few years ago.
High blood pressure. It sneaks up on you.
That was the thing. It's symptomless. Or it was in my case anyway, and you just don't know it's there until it hits you.
That's right. It's known as the silent killing.
That's the one.
Thank goodness in your case it wasn't. Let's see what we can do in today's countdown. Big applause for Mike and Tom. And over in the corner on this Thursday, we have, of course, Susie. And for the last time, until we can persuade him to come back again, great Nicky Campbell. Because, Nicky, excuse me, there are no excuses, because your studio is only across the road.
5 Live.
Where you broadcast every morning between 7 and...
7 and 10.
God, you must get up early.
I've got a flat during the week.
Yep.
On the 22nd floor of one of the buildings here.
Yes.
So I can go out onto the balcony after my shower, naked as the day I was born, to dry myself, you see.
Are you trying to be enticing?
I do. So that's when I'm a raver.
Indeed. Very good. All right. Anyway, more from you in a minute, Nicky. But in the meantime, it's Tom Kappelman's letters game.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Tom.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you. Start today with C.
And another.
R.
And another.
D.
And another.
S.
And a vowel.
A.
And another.
I.
And another.
O.
And another.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, T.
And here's the countdown clock. Yes, Tom.
8.
Mike.
Only 7, I'm afraid.
And your 7?
Raciest.
Raciest, Tom?
Idocraze.
Excuse me?
It's a mineral consisting of a silicate of calcium, magnesium and aluminium. And you will find it in metamorphosed limestone.
Yes.
Amazing.
Very good. Thank you very much for that, Tom. We'll look out for it. And in the corner, what have we got? Nicky and Susie?
Cardies?
Yes. Yeah. Cardies, okay. Good, yeah. Word for seven. Yeah. Couple more. Eights. Carotids, the carotid arteries, and asteroid, another eight.
Asteroid.
Yes.
Well done. Not bad. Not bad. So, Mike, your letters game.
Okay, thank you. Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Mike.
Can I have a consonant, please?
You can, thank you. N.
Another one, please.
R.
One more.
L.
A vowel, please.
U.
Another vowel.
A.
A consonant.
B.
A vowel.
O.
Consonant.
G.
And another consonant, please.
And lastly, D.
Stand by.
Six, not written down.
Six and?
Seven.
Mike?
A bound.
Yes.
A ground.
A ground.
Yes, to run aground, very good.
A ground, yeah.
Mm. Yep. So, Nikki's got that. Anything else?
Nodular is another seven.
Oh, yeah.
Nodular. All right, but a ground takes it on the floor. 15 points, well done, Tom. And now, Tom, it's numbers time. Do your best.
Four large, please.
Four large, your usual now, Tom, thank you. And two little ones, and the first numbers game of the day. And the little ones are 9 and 6. And the big ones, 100, 25, 75 and 50. And the target, 297.
297. Tom.
297.
Mike.
297, not written.
All right, not written down? No, come on then, Mike.
6 times 50.
6 times 50 is 300.
300. 75 or 25 is 3.
Yep.
Deducts.
Nice and straightforward.
Yeah. Good man. And Tom.
Slightly differently. 75 over 25 is 3.
Yep.
Times 100.
Times 100, 300.
9 minus 6 is another 3.
Yep.
And subtract that.
Easy. 297.
Well done. So 25 plays Mike 10 as we begin to a tea time teaser, which is Girl Gang. And the clue, an action performed by the Blue Rinse Brigade. An action performed by the Blue Rinse Brigade. Welcome back. I live through the clue, an action performed by the Blue Rinse Brigade. And it's called gargling. Gargling. Very clever. Gargling. 25 plays Mike's 10. Mike, letters.
Consonant, Rachel, please.
Thank you, Mike. M.
And another one.
S.
Again, please.
T.
A vowel.
I.
Another vowel, please.
E.
Consonant.
N.
A vowel.
O.
A consonant, please, sorry.
T.
And another consonant, please.
And the last one, Q.
Stand by. Thank you. Mike?
Seven.
A seven?
A seven as well.
Mike?
Moisten.
Moisten and?
Moisten.
And moistened. For some strange reason, Susie can't stand that word. So we're not going to ask her whether she's got it.
Just the moist. But the moisten is moist, not too bad. Right. It's just moist.
Yeah. Nikki, anything?
Mittens.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mittens and moisten.
Yes. Mittens is, I think I've mentioned this before, but it comes from Meet, a pet name for a cat, because mittens were often made of cat fur.
Mittens for kittens.
Mittens for kittens, except this time they made the mittens.
Mm. Really? Cat fur? Mm. So Tom, 32, Mike on 17, and now it's over to you, Tom. Letters?
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Tom. C.
And another?
T.
And another?
R.
And another?
N.
And a vowel?
A.
And another?
I.
And another?
E.
And another?
O.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, W.
Countdown. Eight, Mike.
Seven.
And that seven?
Certain.
Thank you.
Creation.
Creation. Oh, very good. Anything else, Nikki? Susie?
I had create, and I was just about to spot the I-O-N.
I know the feeling.
Yeah.
And Susie?
Cortina is an alternative seven. That is, in some toadstools, the thin web-like veil that extends from the edge of the cap to the stalk. Not a Ford car.
There is a place called Cortina, of course, which has a very famous ice run, doesn't it? The Cortina run.
Yes.
Yeah, bobsleigh run. 40 plays 17. Mike, numbers time. Good luck.
One from the top, Rachel, please, and five from the bottom.
Five from the bottom. Thank you, Mike. Five little ones coming up. And for this round, your five little ones are 2, 7, 8, 3, and 5. And the big one, 25. And the target, 435.
435. Mike?
433, sorry.
433, just
yes.
Two away. Mm-hmm. Now, Tom, need I ask?
435.
Of course. So, Tom?
25 times 8 times 2.
25 times 8 times 2 is 400.
5 times 7.
Is the 35.
And add it on.
Is 435. Well done again.
Smashing. Well done. Well done indeed. But now we turn to Nikki. And Nikki, you talked about your passion for conservation yesterday, plight of elephants and rhinos particularly, but your love of animals, of course, starts at home, I understand.
I'm a real dog lover. I love my dogs. I've got two. I've got Maxwell, who's my boy, and Misty, who's a little girl, and she's a West Highland Terrier, and she is expecting at the moment.
Good.
Yeah. She's been betrothed, to put it politely, by a dog that spends all time betrothing. What a life.
It's what a life. A stud.
That's a word for it.
He's a stud, absolutely. And he's a little Westie as well, is he?
Yes, he's a bit sort of bull-like and beefier.
Yeah. You
know, as he's a male dog. So we're very excited about that. I think it's going to be a real family event.
Tell me about the Labrador.
Well, he's great, and he follows me around in the house wherever I go and sits beside me. And he's so loyal and loving. I absolutely adore him, but he's a good guard dog as well.
Mm.
And we were lying in bed one night and he was barking, and my wife said, "That's a very strange bark." And I said, "No, it's foxes, you know, urban foxes, they're everywhere and they drive the dogs crazy." And she said no. And I, right enough, I looked out the window and there's a burglar in the garden, stealing, trying to get a bike over the... It's quite a small garden, but he was trying to get a bike over the fence at the back. So I ran downstairs and I was still completely naked. This is the second naked breath. You're going to think I'm sort of a naturist. So I ran downstairs and ran into the garden, shaking my fist at him, shaking quite a lot of things at him. And he looks at me with horror. I'll never forget the look on his face. It wasn't just I'm being chased out of the garden. It was like, and away he went. And of course, because I'm on the radio every day, I happened to mention it to my colleagues on the radio, and the sports guy went, "Oh, what a story!" And next thing I knew, it was in the papers the next day.
Inevitably.
Naked Inevitably. Nicky chases burglar.
Where was the dog in all this? Apart
barking.
From you should just have let the dog go for him. Did you pause and think, "Shall I pop those pants on?"
I would have put my smoking jacket on and all sorts, but I really didn't have time.
No.
I didn't say to him, please forgive me, I did, but I'm underdressed.
Very good. Thank you very much, Nicky. Now, where are we? We're with Tom again, letters, and you're on 50 to Mike 17. So, off you go.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Tom. R.
And another?
T.
And another?
M.
And another?
F.
And a vowel?
I.
And another?
E. Lastly, F.
Stand by.